Hi, I'm Ryan. I'm a fourth year grad student and I study information theory and network theory in the context of evolutionary biology.
Hi, I'm Jennifer. I'm also a fourth year grad, and I use computer models to study how climate change affects crop growth and yield.
This video explains some things you might expect from a grad school recruitment, which is a little bit different from a job interview. One-on-one interviews with professors are only part of the visit, and recruitment weekend typically includes social events like tours of the campus and city neighborhoods. Grad school interviews are often more informal and conversational than job interviews. Business and casual attire is usually appropriate, and you'll do a lot of walking, so be sure to wear comfortable shoes. You definitely don't need to wear your nicest suit.
You should also expect your flight and accommodations to be paid for. Some departments reimburse your costs afterwards, but if you can't afford this, you shouldn't feel bad about asking the department to pay up front. Most departments will be happy to work with you and make these arrangements.
So let's first talk about the interviews with professors. These interviews are a great opportunity for both you and the professor to gauge the fit of the department and the lab for your interests. You'll learn more about research being done in the department, and faculty members can also learn more about the work you're interested in exploring. You'll typically meet people who work in fields related to the areas of interest you indicate in your application, but you'll also meet some faculty members that work on very different topics.
So faculty interviews are generally conversational and informal. While this may vary person to person, most faculty won't ask you technical questions, test your domain knowledge, or even quiz you on their papers. The important thing is to demonstrate your interest and ability to engage with research topics, and most faculty are eager to tell you more about their work and learn more about your interests.
The professor will likely ask you what you're interested in studying, why you're interested in grad school, and/or why you're interested in that particular university. It's also common to ask you about projects you've worked on in the past, such as undergrad research, coursework, or past jobs. This is a way for faculty to learn more about the kinds of projects you enjoy and how your experiences have gone in the past.
Remember, this is also a chance for you to interview us. Before you arrive, write a list of questions to ask your potential advisor and other grad students. You should come prepared with your own questions that are important to you. Such as how do students receive funding, how much teaching are grads in the lab suspected to do, is there additional departmental funding for travel, research equipment, field work, etc., and what are the requirements to qualify?
You might also want to know how often an advisor holds group or one-on-one meetings with their students, how many publications students are expected to publish during their PhD, and how students from the lab are doing now. These aren't things that you'll find in your information packet, and the only way to know is to ask.
Since you'll be working with your PhD lab for several years, it's also important to get a good idea of the lab culture. You might want to ask professors about their meeting style. Other questions might depend on your specific interests. For example, does the lab interact with other labs that work in related fields?
Be sure to bring your notebook and record your impressions after each meeting. If you do ask lots of questions, you'll gather tons of information that you might forget, especially if you visit multiple schools. But the interview weekend isn't just about meeting professors. You also meet many of the current grad students and other people in the lab. At many schools, a current grad might show you around the school or walk with you to your interviews. Definitely take this chance to ask current grad students about the department, labs, and what it's like to live in that city. You might receive a different perspective on the culture and style of the labs or the region. Grad students are the best resource for honest, non-sugar-coated appraisals of the department and labs.
There are usually planned social activities after the interviews as well, such as a dinner, poster session, or tours of the city and surrounding areas. All your interactions are important, so it's good to stay professional, but this is a great time to relax a little and enjoy some fun activities. The interview weekend is long and can be stressful, so try to stay energized and take time to eat, drink water, and relax whenever possible.
After the interview weekend, it's good to send thank you emails to faculty, grads, and others that you met. Stay in touch with faculty and grads in labs you're interested in. Many are more than happy to answer your questions as you're deciding between offers. Even if you don't end up joining the lab, you might collaborate in the future or see each other at conferences and academic events.
Finally, remember to be yourself, ask questions, take notes, and have fun.
Good luck.
Good luck.